नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आरएसवी ग्रुप ऑफ स्कूल्स वेलकम यू टू क्लास फोर्थ इंग्लिश। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अनदर चैप्टर ऑफ इंग्लिश रीडर, चैप्टर 3 इंग्लिश, किंग शिबी एंड द टू बर्ड्स। लेट्स बिगिन विद द चैप्टर, किंग शिबी एंड द टू बर्ड्स। किंग शिबी वॉज फेमस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड एंड इन द हेवन फॉर हिज काइंडनेस एंड गुड गवर्नेंस। He made sure that every being in his kingdom got justice and lived in peace. Students, this is a story of a famous king who was well known or was popular all over the world and also in heaven for his justice, kindness and good habits. And we can say this thing that everybody who was there in his kingdom was living happily in peace and everybody got the justice. One day, Shibi saw in his garden a wounded pigeon flapping its wing in desperate effort to fly. The king lifted the bird from the ground and wrapped it in its shawl to comfort it. The next moment, he saw a fierce falcon landing on the parapet. Shibi at once realized how the pigeon was wounded and why it looked so frightened. So students, one day when the king was there in his garden, what did he saw? He saw a pigeon who was wounded and was flapping his wings so that he could fly. The king, who was merciful at that very moment, took the bird from the ground and wrapped it in his shawl to give him comfort. At that very moment, what did he saw? He saw a fearful falcon landing on the balcony. And at the same moment, the king realized what has happened to the pigeon and why he looked so frightened. The falcon spoke in human voice. "O king, you are known as a king ruler living for the well-being of your subjects. But today, you are being cruel to me. I saw you guarding that pigeon, which was my prey. Why do you snatch my food from me?" The falcon, it spoke in human voice and told the king that why he has snatched hungry falcon's food. As he was known for his justice, then why he is doing injustice with the falcon? Shibi replied, "O king of birds, this poor pigeon is hurt and tired. It came to my refuge trusting that I would save its life. Just as you do not want to die of hunger, this little bird doesn't want to be eaten by the predator. Please tell me in return for this pigeon's life, what other food can I offer you?" So students, CB King replied in a very polite manner, "Oh, you are the king of birds, and this pigeon is hurt very badly, and it has come with the trust that I will give him food and shelter. If you are not provided with the food, you will die, and if he is not given the service, he is also going to die. So please tell me, what do you want in return for the life of this pigeon? What food can I offer you?" The falcon said, "First choice is everything is food. Without food, we all will die. If I die, my children that have just hatched will not survive either. Please decide if it is right to save one life at the cost of many lives. To protect this pigeon, you are letting my whole family die. Is this justice?" So the falcon said that food is the first choice of everybody, and without food, everybody is going to die. And if I will die, my children who have been just on this earth, who have just now hatched, are not going to survive. So please, you tell me, is this justice that for saving one's life, you are taking the life of many people? And if you are protecting this pigeon, then you are going to take away the life of my whole family. Are you doing justice to me?" and my family? This question from the falcon put Shibi into dilemma. He thought for a while and said, "It is one's supreme duty to protect somebody in danger. A king cannot get away from even his duties if everyone else does. I can give you my whole kingdom if you promise not to harm this pigeon." So the question which was put by the falcon, that at the cost of his and his family life, will he save this pigeon? So the king was in a contradiction. He was in a misconception. He was feeling that what should I do and what not to do to save this pigeon. So at that very moment, he thought and said that saving the life of somebody in danger is the duty of a king, and I cannot deny or defy from my duties, as I have promised this pigeon that I am going to save his life. I can give you my whole kingdom for the life of this pigeon. This is no solution to my problem, persisted the argumentative falcon. I am a carnivorous bird. To give me food, you will anyway have to kill another creature. Does it then make any difference? Consider this solution. Please give me some flesh from your body equal to the weight of this pigeon. So the falcon, it was totally argumenting and continuously, persistent means continuously argumenting with the king and saying, "This is not the solution, because I am a carnivorous animal. I only eat flesh. And to give me flesh, you have to kill some other animal. And it is not going to make any difference, because it is one at the same killing other bird for my food. So give me a solution. And the solution is only that you give me some flesh of your body which is equal to the weight of the pigeon." How well this falcon argues, thought Shibi. It has an accurate sense of right or wrong. So the king was very much impressed. He's saying the falcon is arguing very correctly and he has said the very accurate thing. Shibi at once ordered a balance to be brought. In one of its dishes, he placed the pigeon. He then cut a chunk of flesh from his thigh with a sword and put it in the other dish. Shibi at that very time ordered a balance to be brought, and he placed the pigeon in one of the dish, and then he cut a piece of flesh from his thigh and put it into the other dish. The pigeon dish hung low. Shibi now cut the larger chunk of flesh and placed it in the dish. The pigeon still overweighed the flesh. So Shibi was putting his flesh in the dish, but still the pigeon was more heavier. Again and again the king was doing, but still the pigeon was much heavier than the king's flesh. The pigeon still overweighed the flesh. Shibi kept carving his body until there was barely any flesh left around his bones. The balance was still heavier on the pigeon's side. Finally, Shibi himself mounted on dish, hoping to equal the weight of the bird. So in this way, students, King Shibi gave every part of his flesh on the weight, but still the pigeon was more heavier than King Shibi's flesh. The last option which was left with king was that he mounted himself on the dish, hoping that maybe this time they would be equal. Suddenly divine music filled the air and the heavens showered flowers on Shibi. The falcon and the pigeon disappeared, and in their place stood the king of gods and Agni, the king of fire. So at that very moment, when King Shivi mounted on the weighing machine, or you can say the balance, what happened? Suddenly, beautiful music, we can say that divine means godly music, started, and heaven started showering flowers on King Shivi, and the pigeon and falcon disappeared. At the place of them, God Indra, the king of gods, and Agni, the god of fire, was standing before him. Indra said, "Shibi, Agni, and I came down from the heaven to test you. You have proved that you are far greater than people think." So Indra said, the god of gods said, "King Shibi, I and King and God Agni have came down from the heaven to take a test of yours, and you have proved excellent in the test. People used to say that you are known for your kindness and justice, but you have made it more greater than what people say. You will have a life full of happiness, and you will always be remembered by mankind." So they gave him the boon, or we can say they wished him a life full of happiness, and that people will remember him for his mankind and for the kindness which he has in his heart and the justice which he gave to everyone. Shibi's wounds disappeared as soon as these words were spoken. He closed his eyes in humble prayer as the god vanished. So all the wounds of King Shivi disappeared as Lord Indra, or the king of gods, spoke out these words. And at that very time, when King Shivi closed his eyes to pray to the gods, both the gods vanished. And in this way, students, King Shivi showed his kindness and justice to the whole world. So we can say this thing, that if you are kind, if you are helping somebody, you will get good returns always, and virtues are always paid. So students, we should always be helpful, kind and generous. Hope you have understood the story very well. Thank you and have a nice day.